Now we have covered the Hello World program in Java, and we have understand a very little program, that is a Hello World, that is a first program in the Java. You can give any name in here, like as a class name, and everything will be the same, right? You can give or you can give the package name, or you can give the package name if you are using a single file. Okay, so what I have did here in the inside the main, this is the main of the program, from where the program will start, right? This is the class. If I am removing from here, if we will remove this one, and we are removing this one, right? So there is no problem. Okay, what will happen, it will say ki we have to move into default package, and then we have to save, right? What is the default package? Earlier we are in core Java, and now we have moved into syntax understanding file in the default package. So now we have moved, so there is no problem. You can give any name if you want to give, but recommendation, what is the recommendation? Recommendation is that file name, here file name should be same as the class name in the Eclipse, right? What is the file name? File name is a syntax understanding example dot class, right? So what I have given, the public class or a syntax, right? A public class or syntax understanding example as a class name. This is a class name. And what is the class? Class is a keyword, and public is also a keyword. When we are writing a simple syntax understanding example in Java, it's mean, what is the mean? It's mean that we are writing a class name, or we can writing a Java file with this class name. And if you are writing the main, this is the main, and if you are writing this main, what is the mean? Inside the main method, inside the main class, right? This is not the inner class. We will discuss what is the inner class and outer class. This is a single class. Inside the single class, if you are writing main, it means this is the main class, right? So we can say this is a main class, right? This is a main class. Why is the main class? Because in this class we have main method. Because we have main method. This is the method, main method. What main method is doing? From program will begin. Right? Begin. यहाँ से हमारा जो program है, it will begin. ये हमारा start होगा, and code will start executing. So when the control will come inside a main method, there is nothing is there, right? No any instruction is there. So what will happen if you are writing to print the hello world string value? What will happen? It will check that in the main we do not have anything here, so only one syntax to print, it will give the value hello world as a output, right? So let's discuss the syntax key. What is the syntax of this one? So if you are going through this syntax, public means a class can, if you know C++, it means you are already aware with public, class and those things. If you do not know, means we will tell you key, what is this public comma, you can say public or private, public, private and protected are access modifier in Java. Okay, if you are already aware of C++, then that is no problem, you know. But if you don't know, you can understand, or you can keep a note that public, private and protected are access modifier predefined keyword. You can say this is a predefined keywords. What is this? These are predefined keyword. Okay, this is predefined keyword. These are predefined keywords in Java. So when we are saying about this, what does it mean? This we have just expand the window, so we will understand very well. So public, private, protected are access modifier. Public can be used outside the class. You can write a note in your notebook, like public here, if you write public means this class can be accessed outside the package. If this is inside this package, core Java package, then if there is another class, it can be accessed from here to here. But this is already outside the project, so no worry, we can access here. But we will give you another example, then you can understand. So public, private and protected. Private is you cannot access this class outside the package. So, and protected is similar to that, we can access in the package. So what is happening, if you are writing before, if you are writing access modifier, keep a note that if you are writing access modifiers, what is the access modifiers? Private, public, private and protected. If you are writing the access modifier before a class, it means if it will give you the idea that this class cannot be accessed or can be accessed outside the package or inside the package, you can say, okay. But if you are writing a method, or function, like in Java we call function each as a method, right? So method and functions are same in Java, okay, are same. So keep a note this one also. So if we are writing the class, we are writing a access modifier before class, it means class can be accessed outside the package or not. Or if you are writing the access modifier before the main method, or sorry, before the function, it means you can access this method inside or outside class. This is class, this is class. Class has a boundary between this, right? So if you are writing public, means you can access this method outside the class, okay. Like if we have a method, like if I am giving a method m1, right? We have created a method inside this class, right? So if you are writing anything, if like I am going to keep this one here, let's see. So what will happen, we have given private, what does it mean? We can only access inside this class, but we cannot access m1 as a function, as a method outside the class. So how do we will understand? We will look into that in the future, ki how we will access and those things. Just understand ki what is the access modifier in Java. So access modifiers are public, protected and private, those things are there. So we will discuss more about access modifier in later on. So as we know ki static, if you know about the static keyword will directly connect to class level. We do not need, you can write a note ki static keyword is predefined, right? You can write access modifier and it is done. And if you are writing out static keyword is predefined keyword is this one, and can be accessed directly with class, right? So if you do not want to, it means that you do not want to create object, then static member of access member of class can be accessed directly. Okay, it means what is the means, like if you are we will understand ki what is the members of a class and what is object and those things. Just understand ki what is the requirement of this syntax. So void is, this is done, and now the void is nothing but null, means we do not have a space, something, anything, means without any character it will return. If you are not giving anything here, like if you are removing this one and this one, It will run, but it will not give you anything. So we are writing the void. Void means it will return null. Okay. So we have given this syntax before writing anything. Okay. So this is a very simple program that we have understand till now. So there is one more questions came to you. Like we will understand in the next lecture what are the members in the class and how we'll create object of a class. And if we do not want to create an object, then how we will go for that, right? So what is the, it means what is static and non-static method will be accessed by the class or object. We will understand in the next lecture. So be connected. Thank you.